Crime hits everybody. Everybody ought to hit back. Chicago Crime Commission.
This is NBC.
It's like ivory. Tanaka!
In ancient Japan, the samurai sent this to the man he had sworn to kill.
Well, this one has my address on it. Hi, I'm sure.
I want the pleasure of killing you myself.
Well, at least it's nice to know that I'm wanted.
For her birthday, to make a big hit on a small budget.
A Timex that looks like a million but won't cost it.
What do you get a wife for your anniversary who loves great music?
A Timex Electric, Henny. It keeps the beat without winding.
What do I get my husband, the salesman, so he won't oversleep in Kalamazoo?
A portable Timex mini alarm. It'll wake him anywhere. Timex has over 200 watches for any occasion. Timex, the up-to-the-minute gift.
For my headaches, oh, I need a special pain reliever.
All you need is Bayer aspirin.
Really?
If you need more than Bayer, see your doctor. Bayer aspirin is not 80, not 90. It's 100% pure pain reliever. Bayer adds nothing because you don't need anything else. And millions use Bayer with no stomach upset. Mm. All you need is Bayer aspirin. If you need more than Bayer, see your doctor.
All I need is Bayer.
Security seems pretty tight, but of course that depends on the men and those that want to get past them.
I appreciate your president sending units priority one agent to look after us, Sloane. But I'll be glad to get Maria back to our country where my own security people can protect her. Ah, Maria. We were just talking about you.
Senor Sloane, how nice it is to see you again.
Maria, I don't believe it's you. Every time I see her, she gets prettier. Oh, this is my associate and dear friend, Torque, Maria.
It is a pleasure to meet you, Senorita.
So will the two of you be coming home to San Marcos with my father and me?
No, not this time. Just as far as the airport.
Oh, I see. To be sure nothing terrible happens. Is that the reason?
Maria, please.
Oh, I'm sorry. Please forgive me.
There's nothing to forgive. You have every right to be nervous.
Maria, it's time to begin dressing for your trip.
Well, I'll see you in a little while then.
I think she's handling it very nicely.
I must confess, Sloane, that I too am afraid. Whoever these people are, they have found my Achilles heel. If anything should happen to my daughter.
Do you have any idea who's behind these threats you've been receiving?
All I know is they want me to step down as premier, to replace me with a man they can control.
Your country has always been one of the most stable in South America. Why this sudden attempt to overthrow your government?
Gentlemen, we must understand that though we are a small nation, we share common borders with five larger, richer nations. San Marcos, then, is the keystone to half a continent. I'm certain these people are not my countrymen. They operate on a worldwide scale, and they seem to have unlimited resources.
They do. We call them cartel.
We haven't had a chance to get better acquainted.
Maybe there's time to change that.
Perhaps there is. Who knows? She's in here.
Keeping them. But Duena knows we have to leave for the airport.
And I've been wondering about your guard.
Torque. Torque, we got trouble.
The samurai sent this to the man he had sworn to kill.
Well, this one has my address on it.
Thomas, are you sure it was Tanaka abducted the girl?
Yes. And he made sure that I was sure.
But I thought he was still doing time in that Jakarta prison you put him into.
Evidently not.
Effie, what do we have on him?
According to my instant data scanner, Tanaka spent less than a month in that Indonesian prison. He escaped, made his way to the United States, and set himself up as a leader of a mystic cult.
And in between chance and meditation, he squeezes in a few jobs for cartel.
What about Premier Cassell? Has he been contacted by the kidnappers yet?
No, but I expect they'll make him suffer before they make their demands. Poor Carlos. I think I'll drop by later, see if there's anything I can do. You know, we were in Oxford together. Thomas, have you any idea at all where you're going to start?
No. Epi, that cult of Tanaka's, has he any recent dropouts?
There was a girl named Carrie Baldwin. She was one of Tanaka's most devoted disciples for some time, then suddenly left the group.
Turned against Tanaka.
Sounds like our kind of girl. Where can we find her?
At the Ichiban Kabuki Theater in Little Tokyo.
Sayonara. Oh, Nothing for me today? Don't tell me. It'll blow up a whole city block.
They don't always have to go boom, Thomas. We're in good health.
One semi-large pin? Is that it? Are you trying to tell me something about a relationship, Cal?
Actually, if you carry that around, you'll be telling me something. It's a miniaturized, self-contained microphone transmitter. I can tune in on every word you utter if I'm within a quarter of a mile of you.
You're kidding. This is a bugging device? Well, it's got to be the sneakiest little bug in town.
You better be talking about the microphone, Thomas.
Used to do a little meditating myself, you know.
Why are you here, Mr. Prentice? I didn't send for you.
My superiors in cartel asked me to convey their pleasure at the success of your mission. You will, of course, be rewarded generously. And now I'll just take La Senorita Casal off your hands, if you like.
I do not like Mr. Prentice. She will stay here.
But our agreement...
She will stay here until her father resigns. After that...
Now, see here, Tanaka.
No, you see, Mr. Prentice. The girl stays. Unless you wish to take her away from me.
No. Certainly not. Actually, I was to find a safe place for her, and, this seems perfectly safe to me for the present. We can make the necessary contact with her father from here, certainly. No problem.
I am pleased you see it my way.
It's important to let her talk to her father, Premier Casal, to let him know she's still alive. But not too soon. The effect will be better if he sweats a little first.
Come with me, Maria.
I'm glad I was here to help.
If you're here for tickets, the box office doesn't open till 7.
No, actually, I'm looking for Carrie Baldwin. That wouldn't be you by any chance, would it?
By every chance. Who are you?
My name's Thomas Sloane.
Thomas Remington Sloane?
Yeah, sounds to me like you've heard that name before.
Just about 100 times.
When you were part of Tanaka's cult?
I don't know what you did, Mr. Sloane, but you sure are number one on his hate list.
Well,
I understand he's not very fond of me, but I also understand you're not very fond of him anymore either.
I was very naive when I joined his cult. Like all the others, I was taken in by his beautiful words until I found out they were all lies and he was just using us. I have a lot of friends who've been practically destroyed by him. I was practically destroyed myself.
In that case, you won't mind helping me find him.
What would you want to find him for?
To stop him from destroying someone else, someone young like you.
Tanaka moves around a lot. He always keeps a secret about where he's living. It's possible we might have an address where he's having his mail picked up. I'll go look. They're rehearsing for tonight's performance. Have you ever seen Kabuki, Thomas?
Yes, several times in Japan.
You're lucky. I'll be right back. Tanaka's card. As soon as I was looking at it, someone came from behind me and jumped me and burned it.
There's nothing left. Did you see what it was?
No, he jumped me from behind.
One of the kabuki players left the stage. The lion. The lion always kills for the jackal.
Your father hears about your cavities. You better start using that fluoride paste.
Mom, I need a gel for fresh breath.
Hold on. I got new double protection Aqua-Fresh.
Aqua-Fresh gives you all the cavity-fighting fluoride of the leading paste and all the breath freshener of the leading gel. Concentrated in one toothpaste.
If Aqua-Fresh has fluoride...
And breath freshener.
We'll all have good checkups.
New double protection Aqua-Fresh fights cavities and freshens breath.
Ram Power. Dodge gives you Ram Power.
The new Dodge vans go beyond tough. They're Ram tough. More galvanized steel for critical area rust protection. More than Ford or Chevy. Best mileage ratings with automatic transmission. More than Ford or Chevy.
Dodge trucks are Ram Tough.
Get a Ram Tough Dodge van. Get a $300 check direct from Chrysler. Now at participating dealers.
We had gym that day, so I put my Timex in my pocket. When I came home, my mom was washing clothes, so I put my pants in the wash. I forgot all about the watch. When I remembered, I ran to the dryer. The watch had fallen out of the pocket. My mom said...
It's gonna be ruined.
I just wound it a little and it started to work. And I am proudly honored to say my Timex is perfectly okay.
Timex, it takes a licking and keeps on ticking.
On Disney, Donald's having trouble finding a new job until he decides to go into business for himself. Then... It's Burt Reynolds in the TV premiere of Smokey and the Bandit.
This is Sheriff Cupid D. Justice.
Burt's got a Smokey on his tail, a lady on his lap, and illegal brew in the rig. He's doing it for the money, for the glory, and for the fun.
Mostly for the money.
With Sally Field.
Holy!
And Jackie Gleason.
That's a big 10-4.
Smokey and the Bandit on the big event right after Disney Sunday.
Why have you brought me here, Sloane?
I thought the fresh air might clear your mind.
You brought me here to kill me.
Thomas, please.
Now, don't start feeling sorry for Mr. Sato.
He's only going to get what he deserves.
But does it have to be like this?
You're a little squeamish. Take a walk.
All right. I think I'll go do that.
Come on, Si.
We're going to take a walk.
You would kill me in cold blood?
Sato, I have to tell you, I really admire how you've stood up to interrogation so far. But if you don't tell me where I can find Tanaka in 10 seconds, it's the big sayonara.
Please, you must believe me. I can't tell you where Tanaka is. I don't know myself.
5, 4, 3, 2. Clean shirt in the back. Any trouble finding the car?
No. It was just where you said it would be. You certainly plan ahead, I must say.
Let's just hope that Sato doesn't stop to think how easy it was to jump me. That's where this plan fails or succeeds.
Thomas, I just picked up our man. He's heading toward town.
Dork, are you getting a signal from the beeper we planted in that car?
That's a big 10-4. It's coming in loud and clear.
Disturb me.
Master, I have wonderful news. He is dead. I have killed him. Your mortal enemy, Sloane.
You killed Sloane?
Yes, with his own gun.
You sure it was Sloane?
I'm positive.
I must hear of this face to face. We'll meet, Sato.
Don't harm her. If it's money you want, I will pay any amount.
Don't be naive, Premier Casal. You must be aware that the people I represent could buy or sell your entire country 100 times over. No, money is not the object of this exercise.
Is my daughter there?
Say something to your father.
Papa?
Maria!
I'm so afraid.
Maria, be brave. I will do everything I can to get you home safely. Only you must be a little patient.
Here are our demands, Premier Casal. They must be followed to the letter if you wish to see your daughter again. You will call a press conference. You will announce your resignation as your country's leader. If your announcement is not carried by the local television newscast at 6 o'clock this evening, your daughter will die.
Yes. I understand.
Also, any attempt to find or rescue the girl will be considered a breach of our agreement and will also result in her execution. Do you understand these conditions?
Yes. Yes, I understand. I will do as you say.
Carlos, I know how hard this is for you, but believe me, our best agents are doing everything in their power to find Maria.
They must stop. You must order them to give up the search.
No, Carlos.
No. There is only one way we can save Maria now. And I am determined to do exactly as they say.
It was only after I left the place that I remembered the girl, Carrie Baldwin. I should have gone after her and killed her, too, for betraying you to Sloane.
Carrie, are your ears burning? Sato is really bad-mouthing you.
Don't disturb her concentration, Thomas. She's already spotted two of Tanaka's followers for us.
And there's number three right there.
Getting a feeling we're a little outnumbered.
Keep watching the people in the park. What do you watch for, Master?
A ghost. The ghost of Thomas Remington Sloane.
What is it? Pin!
It's proof that Sloane lives. That you're a fool, Sato. You let Sloane trick you. Then you led him here to me.
But there was blood. I was sure that...
Go away. I hope never to see your unworthy face again. Sloane, join me for a chat.
If you dare.
I just got an invitation to tea.
Are you going?
Work. It's bad manners to turn down an invitation.
Well, I think I'll just stay here nice and peaceful and see to it that Tanaka's friends mind their own business.
Hi there. Here we are again.
Truth, Sloane. I am relieved you're alive.
I want the pleasure of killing you myself. Well, at least it's nice to know that I'm wanted. All this because I outfoxed in Jakarta, huh, Tanaka?
If you had tried to take me with honor, instead with guile and deceit.
Come on, Tanaka. Guile and deceit are part of my business.
But Tanaka does not live in the past, only the future.
Good. When I finish my tea, I'll let you read the leaves.
Sloane, I assure you, you will not be so clever after our final battle.
Now, Mulligan, and when is that supposed to happen? When I take Marie away from you?
So you figure it out.
No. You figure it out for me. Now, give me a clue. How do I solve a problem like Maria?
What? Do I hear the formidable Thomas Sloane asking Tanaka for still more help?
Yes, in plain English, yes. Well, Tanaka?
Some puzzles, Sloane, are more challenging when one thinks they are solved.
Now, what is that supposed to mean? Let's stop the double talk and lay our cards on the table, Tanaka.
Patience, Sloane. You, above all, must learn patience. Now, I must go. Do not be foolish enough to try to follow me.
My men have their instructions, should you be so rash.
Too many innocent people around here, huh?
Until the next time. And I promise, the next time will be the last time.
I certainly hope so.
Tanaka. This is my good friend, Torque. How have you been, Tanaka?
Wounded, little one, by your defection. And offended most deeply that you're a Sloane woman now.
Despite what you might think, I'm not anybody's woman, Tanaka.
Take this. When you hold it, remember how it almost was with you and me. Remember me, little one.
Don't let him frighten you, Carrie.
Hey, with you around, who's frightened?
Tanaka was here? Any trouble?
No, just a puzzle.
Looks like ivory. Feels like ivory.
Farewell, little one. I hope you become very dear to Sloane.
Child's dream come true. It's a moment of love, a joyous sensation.
Okay, son.
Ooh.
Come on, and have a Pepsi day. Come on, and taste the Pepsi way. Come on, and have a Pepsi day.
Well, I'm Jim McKay.
No, I'm Jim McKay for Timex. The most extraordinary thing about this quartz digital watch is not that it tells you the time all the time, night and day. Not that it's 99.997% accurate. Not that it costs only $32.95. Nope. The most extraordinary thing is... it's a Timex.
A Man Called Sloane was brought to you tonight in part by Timex. Timex is over 200 watches for any gift occasion for men, women, or children. Timex, the up-to-the-minute gift.
A Man Called Sloane will return.
Monday, Mary and Adam anxiously await the birth of their child. Maybe too anxiously.
I really think you should put your pants on.
A joyous celebration on Little House.
Wednesday, check in to Samurai Hotel with guest host Richard Pryor.
Open funny.
It's an hour of laughs as the best of Saturday Night Live returns.
It's always something.
Okay, you guys, just wait till you try this new pizza. It is something.
It's a great big pan full of pizza.
Pizza Hut presents new Sicilian pan pizza.
There's all kinds of cheese on top, and the crust is really thick.
Big pizza, and there's so much piled on top.
Pizza. Not gonna... it takes a pan to hold it all.
New Sicilian pan pizza from Pizza Hut, made by hand right in the pan.
Boy, is it ever good.
We're coming in to Pizza Hut, coming in for good.
For new Sicilian pan pizza.
Saudi Arabia says cut oil profits or pay more. Details at 10.
Effie, do we have anything on the tape recording of the phone call we made of Sada's voice yet?
Yes, Thomas. An analysis of the dial clicks indicates he was calling a number in the valley.
Did we get an address to go with the number?
According to phone company records, that particular number is located at 1901 West Pine Street.
Good. But I'm sure it's only a relay station of some kind.
Sato had to ask to be put through to Tanaka.
Well, let's hope this time you'll get lucky.
Well, there's always that possibility.
Alert Torque to meet me up there.
What's she like?
She?
Your secretary, Effie.
She makes a terrible cup of coffee, but she has a mind like a computer.
Tanaka, we're running out of time. I have to talk to you about the girl.
You are interrupting a ritual of purification, a sacred rite of samurai.
I'm sorry, it can't be helped.
What is it you must say to me about the girl?
You have to release her to me, now.
No!
Cartel wants her out of the country before the 6 o'clock deadline.
No!
What do you mean, no? You've done what we hired you for. We have deposited $2 million to your Swiss account. Your part of it is finished, done.
Why do you want the girl? You have no intention of returning her to her father, no matter what he does.
Of course not. We'll continue to hold her as a safeguard that he doesn't try to resume power in San Marcos at some later date.
Very well. Continue to hold her as long as you like. But here, in this house.
This purification thing, this ritual, it's something you do before combat, isn't it?
I'm flattered you take an interest in my beliefs.
Combat with whom, Tanaka? With Sloane, maybe. You want the girl here because you want Sloane to try to find his way here and try to rescue her. Then you can have your revenge on the man who caused you to lose face.
It is that simple.
Then you don't leave me any choice, Tanaka.
Your friend, too, will be at my feet.
There it is over there, Thomas. 1901 West Pine Street.
The house of three doors. Gentlemen only?
Well, what do you think?
I'll flip you.
No, no. I know that coin of yours. George Washington's head is on both sides. I'll flip my own.
Call it. Tails.
Who's going to go around the back?
You are. It's your coin.
Welcome to the House of Three Doors. Which one is your desire?
Well, it depends.
It usually does. The first door. Her name is Aphrodite. Her specialty, Far Eastern chants.
I believe it.
But you seem like a man of more intellectual taste. Venus. She took her doctorate in French literature.
French? Nothing like a good education.
And then there's a Diana.
Don't tell me. Diana? Diana plays the violin.
The viola.
Well, I was close. What about that door?
I'm sorry, but that's the office.
That's the one I'm interested in.
Just a second there. You can't go in there.
You want to bet?
Please make your acquaintance.
Are you all right, Thomas?
Never better in my life. It's a very sophisticated communication system you have. Now, if I wanted to call Tanaka, how'd I place the call?
You think you're going to trace the line to the samurai? Forget it. From here, the call is relayed by radio phone. You just try tracing a radio signal.
It would seem he's telling the truth, Thomas. He has a radio hookup.
Well, I guess you'd have to make a phone call for us.
No way.
There's one way.
I've been waiting for your call, Sloane. I knew you would find a way to get in touch with me.
Well, now that I have, why don't you give me your address?
I intend to, but after 6 this evening.
You mean after the news tonight? Is it really that important to you that Premier Casal resigns?
Only because it makes your failure complete, Sloane. You must taste the bitterness of total defeat before you die.
Ah, you talk a lot. I wonder if you're worthy of being called a samurai.
What do you mean, Sloane?
You're a man without honor.
I challenge you to single combat.
With one condition, the prize, Maria Cassell's life.
And I accept your challenge, Sloane.
Then tell me, where are you?
There is a house at the end of Old Canyon Road.
There you will find me. But I warn you, Sloane, if you come before 6, or if Cassell does not resign, the girl dies instantly.
Well, at least we know where he is.
But how will we get him without risking Maria's life?
I don't know, Twerk. We've got less than 1 hour to figure it out.
Thomas, and I'm preparing to set up the equipment.
You realize if you try anything, the girl will be killed.
Where is she?
After our match, Sloane.
Tanaka. Not until I find out if she's alive first.
You have my word.
Now, why isn't that proof enough?
And suppose I refuse to give you any more?
Then Premier Cassell doesn't make that resignation speech.
Well, I don't believe that is the case.
Believe it, Tanaka.
Yes? Yes, Master. I'll be right there. You, come with me.
It would be a mistake to confuse the two.
That's the last thing I want to do right now. Make a mistake.
Yes, Tom.
It'll be all right. It's going to be all right, Maria.
Oh, I'm so afraid.
You're going home to your father, your country, and to your friends.
Okay.
Trust me.
Take her back to her room.
Let's go.
Sloane, time is running out. Now that you're satisfied she is alive, shouldn't you contact Premier Cassell?
Premier is set to make his speech. either way.
Do you really think this is going to work, my friend?
Carlos, I don't think there's any other choice.
I suppose you're right. I'm sure they have no intention ever returning, Maria.
Director speaking.
Mr. Director, this is Tork. We have our transmitter beamed in on Tanaka's TV antenna.
Are you sure it's strong enough?
Yes, sir, I'm positive.
All right. Now, set the timer for exactly 6:05.
I'm at 6:05 and counting, Mr. Director.
We're ready for you. Good luck.
Thank you, sir. I think we'll be needing all we can get.
My name is Tork, and I'm a one-man maintenance crew. I can fix anything from drain pipes to air conditioners. And that house up there looks like it's in need of my services.
Forget it and stay where you are.
Look, I misjudged you. Is the lady of the house in?
There is no lady of this house.
Oh, well, what about the garage? Is there something I can do there? I can tune anything on wheels. Oh, maybe you're the man I should be talking to about work. Hey, listen. I'm the guy they had in mind when they originated the word handyman. You wouldn't believe the things I can do with this. Look, the fingers come off, all of them. And not only do the fingers come off, when they do, I can put other attachments on them. Now look at this. This is a saw for sawing anything I want to saw. It works just perfectly. If I don't want to use the saw, I can attach other objects. And this is really a handy little number.
What does that do?
Well, this gets rid of termites. And any other nuisance there might be.
Make yourself comfortable, Sloane. It won't be long now.
Now for a special news broadcast. Live from Premier Carlos Casal's temporary residence here in Los Angeles.
I deeply regret that personal difficulties make it necessary for me to resign as Premier of San Marcos, effective immediately.
Looks like your set needs a few new transistors. Must be one of those cheap imports.
It is with great sadness and the keen sense of personal loss that I lay aside my duties. But my decision is firm and final.
Satisfied, Tanaka? The whole country will go down the tubes because of you and Cartel.
Indeed, Sloane. I have the best of all possible worlds. My work for Cartel is finished, and you're here to be killed by me. Now, shall we get to that?
Thank you.
time to film this for show and tell?
The cameras. Let me explain about the cameras. They are part of some new rules I decided on. First, you and I, Sloane, we will fight to the death. Our fight will be monitored in the room where Maria Casal is being held by one of my followers.
Should I kill you, Sloane, the girl will be released unharmed. However, should you manage to defeat and kill me, the girl will be instantly put to death.
You call that a good deal?
You can take it.
From the kitchen. This tree has hardly been touched.
Go away! The girl don't want to eat.
Torque.
Is that gratitude for you? What if I had taken 30 seconds longer?
Well, I guess I can't argue with that.
To all my dear friends, whom I'll never be able to repay,
thank you. Thank you. From the bottom of my heart.
Some of that thanks belongs to you.
I'm just glad Tanaka gets what he deserves. But I do have a confession, Thomas Remington Sloane.
What's that?
I never really learned to appreciate champagne. And as for these little pieces of toast with the fish eggs all over them...
You'd rather have a big, thick, juicy hamburger?
You bet I would.
That makes two of us.
That makes three of us.
I don't think we have to say goodbye. Now, I know this is my little hamburger stand on Sunset.
Thomas? Tork?
You weren't thinking of leaving, were you?
As a matter of fact, we were.
It's still early. Look at all that caviar, patty de foie gras, etc.
But no hamburgers.
No hamburgers? By any chance going to that little stand on Sunset?
Would you like to come with us?
Oh, I couldn't. There is such a thing as protocol. But after all, Carlos and I are such very old friends. On the other hand, I suppose he would like to spend some time alone with his daughter.
We'll save you a seat, sir.
Do. Do that. And order me a double burger with everything on it.
Next week's
Sloane and a beautiful Soviet spy band together to stop the Sweethearts of Disaster, a deadly female squad of guerrillas who plan to sabotage a secret Middle East peace conference. Robert Conrad is A Man Called Sloane, next Saturday night on NBC. Stay tuned now for an encore presentation of NBC's Saturday Night Live with host Jack Burns and musical guest Santana, following local news next.